I think you're building up your profile in the council, and one way you're doing that, I think, is through the Children, Young People and Skills Committees. I think we were going to start off by, well, first of all, you know, I think you were going to talk about what the committee does, because I think when people ask me or people ask about what a council does, I mean, one of the answers I always give is, well, they look after vulnerable children and vulnerable adults, and you're partly responsible for some of those policy decisions on the committee, aren't you?
Oh, absolutely. So one of the core, and in fact, statutory duties a local authority has is to look after vulnerable children, and of course there's many children who need to unfortunately be taken into care. They need to obviously have their education provision, but they also need to be put into the right kind of environment to ensure that they still have good life chances. You know, if for whatever reason the parents cannot look after the children that they have.
And what have you been working on in the committee recently?
I have taken a view to look more closely at schools. That is something I'm very interested in, and to look at the overall council performance on schools.
And we have some excellent schools in the Brighton Hove area, so you're a school governor as well, I think, at Varndean.
Balfour.
Balfour
Primary. It's on the Varndean campus, so yes. Same kind of area. But yes, so unfortunately our school went into requires improvements last year after Ofsted. There were particular issues about why that was identified in the report, which of course is, and quite rightly, made public. We had some problems, particularly with our disadvantaged students and their outcomes. So because of that and a couple of other issues to do with outcomes, that pulled down our rating to requires improvement, which of course is just one above failing. So that's not where we want to be. But the good news is that it gives you a renewed focus as a school to look and drill down and really identify those areas. And we've over the last year, we've had a great deal of work. I'm the pupil premium / disadvantaged governor. So I've been looking at those issues with the acting headmistress. And, you know, I'm very confident that we're going to improve. We've had some very good data from the last school year. So the change at Balfour has been really beneficial. Sometimes you need that exogenous shock to really jolt you out of complacency, which I think is where we were as a school.
Yeah.
And I think complacency might describe, if I'm not being too unfair, the council's approach to schools. I understand it. The big challenges in the children's department have been obviously budgetary pressures. Nationally, there has been an increase in looked after children. And we did see that. Obviously, there's been high profile cases, especially, you know, child sexual exploitation, all those kinds of really sad issues. That's led to an almost an explosion of investigations, and people have referred services to children's services. So, cases to children's services, sorry. So people have really, the council's really had to grapple with that. That of course has meant if you're looking after more children or you've got more cases, there's obviously a cost pressure to that. So the council's been focusing on that. Budgets are obviously finite. I think it's taken its eye off the ball and on schools. Now, if you look at the Ofsted rating, for the most part, we're doing okay. Secondary school wise, all our schools are now rated good. But there's obviously, good is actually quite a wide, it's quite a wide measure of overall performance, in that you might have some just about good schools, you might have very good schools, just touching outstanding. So for instance, the King's School, which obviously is not a council school, it's a free school set up in 2013.
Yeah.
So it's part of the Govian education reforms. So it's run by the Russell Educational Trust, and it's a faith school as well. It's an Anglican faith school. And it's got two good categories and two outstanding categories. So hopefully it will become an outstanding school over the next few Ofsted inspections, and it's had some very good performance as well in its first batch of GCSEs.
Dorothy Stringer's meant to be one of the best state schools in the country, or has been voted upon that in the past. So we do have some of the best schools in schools in the country.
We do, and that is not to diminish their successes at all.
Yeah.
What I think the problem is that we have as a city is that there is still a very stubborn and persistent gap between disadvantaged students and their performance of non-disadvantaged students. And I think that is And that is a strategic priority for the committee. Back in 2015, Councillor Tom Buick, when he was chair of the Children, Young People and Skills Committee, he set up four strategic priorities, and one of them was to diminish the difference between disadvantaged and non-disadvantaged students. And in my mind, I don't think we're making as rapid progress at all. In fact, I think I'm right in saying that actually we slipped backwards slightly. The gap does seem to be getting bigger. So we've really got to have a renewed emphasis, I think, on that, because ultimately your educational outcome should not be determined by where you happen to live. I think that's incredibly unfair.
Okay, well, thanks for coming in to this episode of The Vote today, Nick.
Not at all.
And yeah, we'll catch up again soon.
Brilliant. Well, thank you ever so much.
Cheers, thanks.